で16秒です。岩槻街道の近くです、国道16は。岩槻やと。 大丈夫です。Subtract signals high to one layer, we can send it into the carrier. So we can that same signal.
So we have a little bit connected there. And one of these display to say when we had our ALU output, which we call EO, sorry, the device is called that, but this is our output signal for the ALU, then when that output signal goes active, what we want to do is output the results of the arithmetic. So we're performing, in order to perform the arithmetic, we need to know what the outputs are. So we have our A register and our D register. We're actually going to connect the inputs of the A register directly to the ALU and the inputs of the B register directly to the ALU. So in this case, you can imagine if all the ALU is doing is adding, and it's just doing addition, then this is really all we need, right? Because it's going to know there's an A register, we've got our 6 in this case going into the ALU, we've got our other operating data, or 2 going into the ALU, so getting a 6 and a 2 coming in, and so we can output 7 of those if you output 8, whenever our output signal is active. But if we want to do subtraction, then we need another signal here to say subtraction. And so we'll call output the SU, the subtract signal. And so in that case, if the subtract signal is active, then the sum signal is also active, the output, the subtract and the output are both active, then instead of outputting the sum, we'll output A minus B, just outputs the difference of A and B. So this is enough to know that this is essentially what we want to build. It's the circuit that does this. It has an output signal, it has a subtract signal, whether we're subtracting or adding, which is what this input tells us. And it's directly connected to the registers, directly connected to the registers, that's how it gets its inputs. So if we want to add two numbers, we've got to put one number in the A register, we've got to put another number in the B register, but then we can set the inputs permanently and get the output back out of the document. Do the addition is using the 74LS283, which is a 4-bit adder. And if you want to know how a 4-bit binary adder works, I've got a video where I build a 4-bit adder from the logic gates. So you can go back and take a look at that video. I recommend that link it down below. But that video walks through exactly how this works from logic gates and everything. But since we look at that video, we know how it works. I'm going to take a shortcut and use this chip, which has a 4-bit adder built into it. It is a 4-bit adder, I guess. And so if you look at the pinout here, we can see we've got A1, A2, A3, A4. That's our 4-bit A input, and then B1, B2, B3, and B4, and the 4-bits of our second input. And then it has these outputs, signal 1, signal 2, signal 3, and signal 4. And we use the signal to indicate sum, because that's the output. It's also the C mode for the output of the ALU, because this just kind of has to vary to refer to the results of some arithmetic calculation, or particular addition or summation with a signal, capital sigma. So this one kind of sort of looks like a signal. So just kind of a convention there. So we've got the 4-bit input, the second 4-bit input, and the 4-bit output on this chip. We've also got the carry in and carry out, and that'll let us cascade these together, which is another reality for a 4-bit binary adder works. There's actually 4 4-bit adders with the carry with carry of 1 bit going to carry of the next bit, and then the carry of that bit going to carry in of that, first carry out of 1 bit going into the carry in of the next bit. And so we can cascade, we continue to cascade down 4 by using these carry in and carry out. C0 is the carry in, C4 is the carry out. So we use this 4-bit adder, and so I'm just going to redraw that a little bit here. So we've got our, what I'm kind of showing here is we've got our 4 inputs coming from the A register, and then we have 4 inputs coming from the B register, and then we've got 4 outputs, which are going to go out to our bus. So that's our 4-bit adder. Of course, we don't need the computer, we don't have 4-bits, we want 8-bits. So we can even cascade a second 4-bit adder like this. So now we have our 8-bits coming from our A register, we've got 8-bits coming from our B register, and then we've got 8-bits over here going out to our bus. And then we're just taking the carry out from one of the adders and just connecting that directly to the carry in of the other adder, and that essentially builds for the 8-bit adder. So we can add 8-bits plus 8-bits, and get the result. So remember, we don't always want to output the result here. We don't want to output the result when we have this sum out signal active. So what we can do is the same thing we did with our registers, which is use this tri-state logic here. So we have our outputs over here, and then we put them into these tri-state buffers, and then we connect the data of all of these buffers together. And this is our sum out. This is our O, or sum out signal. So when this is active, then we're asserting the results of our addition onto the bus. And when this is inactive, then we're not bringing the bus either high or low, which will disconnect from our bus. How do we do subtractions? This is good for addition, right? We can add one number plus another number, then we get the result over here, and then we can selectively enable whether that's going out of the bus or not. But what about subtraction? So if we want to subtract the contents of the B register from the A register, how can we do that? Well, one way would be to